polynomials in that division method and remainder method. First, I will go the division method. You have studied in your division method in your 8th standard division method of the polynomials. You studied this one. How much you remembered, I don't know, but it's important, okay? Don't forget it. Okay, I will take one question. divide p of x by g of x. It's two also polynomials, okay? So I will take the question. P of x is x plus 3x square minus 1. G of x is 1 plus x. So division method we have to do. See students, before going for the division method, one thing you remember always, what given questions must be in the order of the powers. Correct order, it may be there in the correct order. See, now it's not there. Here power 1 is there, here power 2 is there. So write in the proper way with the sign you have to write. Plus 3x square here, plus 3x square first. After 3x square, x, this sign contains plus here. Minus 1. Now this is a p of x. Okay, g of x also, 1 plus x is there, so I'll write x plus 1. Like this you have to arrange. While arranging time, don't change the sign, original signs you don't miss up. Now we have to go for the division method. Okay, I will divide now. This you had, easy it is, but you have to understand how to do. X plus 1. See students, listen carefully. Take the first term of the p of x, take the first term of the p of x and first term of the g of x, divide. 1x is there, no? Is it 1x here goes? How much remains now? 3x remains. See, 2 minus 1, 2 minus 1. Power is subtracting when the bases are same in the division. 2 minus 1 means 1. So 3x remains. That 3x here, write as a quotient. Okay, write as a quotient. Now, from this quotient, you have to multiply for the both. 3 into x, x square. See, our intention, we have to make the first term same. That you remember. Our intention, we have to make the first term same. That reason we are dividing here. Next, be careful about the sign. Plus is there. Plus. 3x into 1. 3x. See, we have to multiply for all the terms what is there here. Now, not finished. You have to change the sign. While changing the sign, you have to see the lower line of the problem. See, it is plus here, so it is minus. Plus here, so plus 3x square minus 3x square gets cancels and comes 0. Here nothing is there, means 1. Okay, here minus, after changing the sign, you have to consider the changed sign, not the original sign. Remember, here plus 1 is there, here minus 3 is there. You write in the side, otherwise you are going wrong. Plus 1 is there, minus 3 is there. 1 plus 1 minus means we have to subtract. You have to take the bigger number sign. Minus 2, coefficient is same, x. Then this remains as it is. Next, this much understood, I think. When here comes minus, automatically you write the minus sign here first. Don't miss. When here minus comes, you write minus here. Other things afterwards you can do. Now, I said again, one step we finished. Now, once again, this one's first term, sign I written here, no need to take once again. This one's first term, same. Each step you have to do like that only. Here, x cancels, remaining only 2. So, 2. Now, be careful students, here minus 2, it is not only 2, it's minus 2. While multiplying with the minus also, you have to multiply here. Minus 2 into x, minus 2 into x, what it is? Minus 2x. So minus 2x. I said our intention, we must get this one same with the sign, everything we must get this one same. Minus into plus, minus 2 into 1, 2. One more method is there without taking minus, that no need, afterwards you are confusing. So you study like this only. Okay, now once again, don't forget to change the sign always. Minus is there, plus, minus is there, plus. Plus 2, minus 2 cancel. Here, minus 1 plus 2. 1 plus 1 minus subtraction, bigger one is plus. Over. Now we cannot because it is smaller than g of x. This is the problem. Now we have to verify. We know the verification formula is there. You know how much you know, I don't know. Okay, I will tell. Now it is, I said p of x. This is the g of x. This is the quotient. Quotient is q of x. This is the remainder, that is the r of x. So our formula says dividend means what? P of x. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder. You have studied in your small class. That only formula comes here, but showing way in the polynomials. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor or divisor into quotient, both are same, plus remainder. Okay. Now dividend is what? 3x square plus 1x minus 1. This as it is you give. Q of x is what? 3x minus 2 quotient. This is the g of x plus r of x. See now, don't touch this one. This one we have to get while simplifying this. Okay. Multiply binomial to binomial. Remember, no? 3x into x, 3x square. 3x into 1, 3x. First one to both. Second one to both. Remember, minus 2 into x, minus 2x. Minus 2 into 1, minus 2, plus 1. 1x square term is there, so as it is, right? X terms are 2. 3 minus 2, 1x. Here, minus 2 plus 1. Minus 2 plus 1. That is 1. My bigger one is. See, have you got same? Yes. Then you are correct. In the verification, if you got p of x equal to this, then you are correct. So, this is the verification of the division. Now, one more is there. They may ask. This is all I will grab, okay? Okay. They may not asking you to divide. Without dividing, you can find out the remainder. How? They may ask, find the remainder of these two. Find the remainder of these two. So, how to find? See, g of x you have to take now. G of x equal to x plus 1. This one you have to take. X plus 1 is equal to 0. Then, x equal to what? X equal to minus 1 it becomes. Isn't it? Understood, no? G of x we have to take it as 0. Then we have to get the value of x that you know, x equal to minus 1. Now that x equal to minus 1, you have to substitute for the p of x. P of x is what now? 3x square plus x minus 1. Now in the place of x here, minus 1. G of x, x value. Understood, no? 3 into minus 1 the whole square plus minus 1 minus 1. 3 into minus 1 the whole square means minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Is it plus 1? Plus into minus, minus 1, minus 1. So, 3 into 1, 3 minus 1, minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. See the remainder. It's easy. This is only applicable to find the remainder. Here we are not getting the quotient. See, please read the question carefully. If they asked to find the remainder, then you go for this method. If they asked to find the quotient and remainder, you go for this method. If they asked to find the quotient and remainder and verify, you have to verify. These three are there in this topic, what I have taken today. It's easy. Next one more problem I will solve. This is called as remainder method, okay? Finding the remainder is called as remainder method. Remainder method, division method, verification, all are important. One question I'll take. P of x equal to 3x to the power 4 minus 4x cube minus 3x minus 1 by x minus 1. Divide this by that. First I will do the division method, long division method. Next I will go for the remainder method and verification if you want. Okay. Now I will go for the long division method. It is there in the power wise. While writing here, if any power is missed, you have to write 0. See here, 3x to the power 4 is there. Okay, 3x to the power 4 is there. X cube term is there, but x square term is not there. So write 0x square minus 3x minus 1. Remember, here also, power missed means you have to write 0x square. Or 0 into what power is missed to that? 3x to the power 4 minus 4x cube plus 0x square minus 3x minus 1. Yeah, multiply. I said here, take this one's first term and this one's first term. Here 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1 is 3. So 3x to the power 3. 3x to the power 3. Multiply 3x to the power 4 minus 3 into 1. 3x to the power 3. Change the sign. Minus here, it is plus here. Cancels. Minus 4 plus 3. 1 greater 1 is minus, so minus. Minus 1x to the power 3. As it is, write the next one. Now once again, I said here minus comes means you write a minus here. Afterwards, remaining work you do. Here 1x cube is there. Here x is there. 3 minus 1, 2. So x square, 1x square. So 1 is not written, no problem, x square. Minus is there, so minus into minus, plus minus, x into x, x cube. If you want 1, you write. Minus into minus plus, minus into minus plus, that is x square. Here change the sign, don't forget in each step we have to change the sign. Okay, cancel. Minus 1 plus 0, minus 1 x square. Once again, here minus. Here x square is there. There x is there. 2 minus 1 means x to the power 1. Power I am subtracting. Understanding? 2 minus 1 power, not some other numbers. Okay. So here x comes. X into x. Sorry. Minus into minus plus minus. X into x. X square. Minus into minus plus. X into 1. X. Change here once again. Yeah. Minus 3 minus 1, minus 3 minus 1, both are minus. I have to add and sign minus. Okay, now it's just minus here. Here 4x is there x is there, cancel. So remaining is 4. 4 into x, minus 4 into x, minus 4x, minus into minus, plus 4 into 1, 4. You are, if you forgot minus is there, then while here minus is there, here also minus should come. That time you can remember, minus I have to multiply. Like that you think. Change. Little gap you keep, okay, here. While changing the sign, don't rush here. Minus 4 minus 1, minus 5. So remainder we got it as minus 5. Now I will go for the remainder method and I will check. Just to see what remainder we will get here. I'll go for the remainder method. I said g of x, let g of x is what, x minus 1 is equal to 0. So we will get x equal to coming here plus 1. So I'll substitute that plus 1 here. P of plus 1 is equal to, p of x is there given here, 3, x to the power 4. So 1 to the power 4 minus 4 x cube, 1 cube minus, now no need your power missed means taking 0, that no need, you can leave. Or you can take, no problem. 1. 3. 1 to the power 4 is 1 only. 1 cube is 1 only. 4 ones are 4. 3 into 1, 3. Minus 1. Okay. Next you see here. 3 minus 4. 3 minus 4. 1. Get minus. Then minus 3. Both are minus. So add. Then minus 1. See. What we got? Same. Minus 5. Minus 5 as a reminder. Understood? So this is easy, isn't it? So I think you understood the division method and the remainder method. Okay. Next, only using the remainder method, I will take two problems. Find, they asked, check whether the polynomial is in the question. Check whether the polynomial q of t is equal to 4t cube plus 4t square minus t minus 1. Here t, why? Because the variables are t. They asked to check whether this is a multiple of 2 plus 1. 2t plus 1. So means it is a p of x, it's a g of x. We are given p of t or g of t, anything, no problem. Is this is a multiple of this? So now what we have to do? That in the remainder method, enough. No need. Now they did not say for us to divide. They will mention if you want divide, they will mention, or find q of x and g of x, they will mention. That time only you go for the division method, otherwise go for the remainder method. But little here, see, 2t is there, it's coming here minus 1, t becomes, fraction comes minus half. Careful, okay. Okay, now this minus half, I have to substitute here q of minus half. Okay. 4 into minus half to the power 3 plus 4 into minus half to the power 2 minus t minus half, both 2 minus are there, careful. 4 minus half, minus half, minus half. Minus into plus, minus into minus, plus, plus into minus, minus, 2, 2, 2, 4, 8, minus 1 by 8, I think you know the multiplication, 4, minus square becomes plus, half into half, that becomes 1 by 4, minus, minus, plus, minus, correct, understood, yes, it can means cut, ones or twos, no problem, minus half comes, first one, here plus 1 comes, here plus half comes, here minus half comes, here plus half, plus 1, minus 1. So 0. When you are getting 0, then you can say it is a multiple of this. Okay, if they asked, check whether it is a multiple of this or not. If they asked, while doing a remainder method, you must get a 0. Then it is a multiple of that. Correct. Yes, it is a multiple of, continue the question. Okay. Yes. This is the method. Okay, next we see the next class for the factorization. Thank you.